So today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about the importance of rhythm. And if you close your eyes when you're in a group and you listen to a bunch of people talking, you can hear that there is a rhythm to language. And when your baby learns rhythm, your baby is also being ear-trained for future literacy training, learning a new language, and also for musical training. So rhythm is very important. And most people use rhythm in their lives very naturally. You can see a little link, you know, if you hold your baby and you sway with your baby and you kind of rock back and forth and you bounce your baby, you're teaching your baby's rhythm. And they can hear the rhythm of your heartbeat and the rhythm of your breath. And that's really all that your baby needs to learn, a sense of rhythm. Now, if you've got a toddler, a really fun way to learn rhythm is to play the toddler drum. So if you put them, you can, you know, have them sit in front of you and have them say either an ah or an e and pat their back as they do it, so it becomes a ah kind of sound. They think that's really fun. And then they, of course, will want to play the mommy drum or the daddy drum, so have a good time with that. When you have older kids, it's a great thing to do to play a game where you're making rhythm a conversation. So you can use your knees, you can use your hands, you can bang on the sofa or bang on pots and pans, and just bang out a rhythm and see if they can do the same thing and just imitate that. And then you can start to have a conversation and just maybe pick a topic. Say, let's have a conversation about rain. And then you can make a little sound and then see if they respond back to you. Maybe they send you some lightning. So have fun with it, because rhythm is really important, and rhythm is a very fun thing to be sharing with your children.